Hi guys, so it's time to talk about the youngsters in Sri Lanka cricket. I mean, the ones who are performing really, really well. We have a number of youngsters who have been doing really well in the Premier League tournament as well. And one such talent is Pathum Nissanka. He has been performing really well for the Sri Lanka A team, for the emerging team, for NCC. And let's look how he has performed. And let's see who are the other players who has a potential in getting. Now plays for NCC and has showcased his talents playing for the SL Emerging Team and Sri Lanka A Team. He was born in Kalutara, his school is Kalutara Vidyalaya, and then previous scholarship he goes to Isipathan College. He's still 20, he plays for NCC, but as 20-year-old kid he has performed exceptionally well. Pathum scored a match-saving double century few days back against Ireland A team playing for the Sri Lanka A team. This is his third score of 450 in the past month and the second double century in the same period. 1 month has passed by and in that period he has scored two double centuries and three scores over 150. Now that's something really remarkable. I would say within a month you scoring three scores of 150 and then having two double centuries in that is something really, really impressive from this young man. His last 10 first class innings read as follows: 217, 4, 26, 11, 84, 163, 206, 27, 74, and 188. 10 innings, and you find how many double centuries there. 2 double centuries, and another 2 more scores over 150. 163, 188 is over 150, and then again you can put 206 and 270. So, 4 scores over 150 in the last 10, plus 2 double centuries, and then he has made 2 more half centuries as well, 84 and 74. This shows how confident this batsman is and how stable and how consistent this batsman is. Pathum is carrying an excellent first class record with an high average of 68. He is having high average of 68 so far, and his first class record is currently as follows. That is a really, really impressive thing. His first class record is something that is really, really good. I mean, he has been performing very well. I mean, if you're having an average of 68, that's something remarkable. That speaks a lot about the player. So far, Pathum has played 19 matches, and in 35 innings, he has got 1,961 runs in 35 innings with a high score of 217 and average of 68.31. First class average of above 50, in this case it's above 60, is something really good. 68.31, a first class average for a 20-year-old boy having 700s and 750s. So out of the 35 innings, you can see 14 innings he has been very, very consistent. 700, 750s. Once he makes a start, he continues his good form and converts them to good scores. All those centuries that they made are very big ones. You have 160s, you have 180s, you have 200s. So he goes on to score a long inning. He has been opening the batting, he has been playing at number 4. I mean, the position really doesn't matter to him. So we thought of, you know, talking to Pathum, and what he has to say was this. We from Ceylon today spoke to Pathum. So talking to Ceylon today, Pathum said that he is really happy about the performance during the past 2 months. I usually bat at number 4 for my club, NCC, and perform there very well. And in the recent Sri Lanka A matches, I opened the batting and registered another double century. I have no issues with the position, and as a batsman, I am doing what I am required to do, giving my best, said this elegant right-hander. he has been opening the batting for the Sri Lanka A team, and then his club is NCC. He has been playing at number 4. There he has scored double centuries. He comes, open the batting, and once again he has been doing that. Well, just on a personal note, the national team doesn't have a stable opening partner for Dimuth Kalmaratne. And this young Pathum can be a good contender for the opening slot. I mean, we have seen so many players coming and going. Because Dimuth is fixed there. You see, Dhanush Gunthera coming and batting. He comes, he goes off. Kausha Silva comes, you know, score, play too much, he goes off. Well, Thirumal might play in the Australian series. So we have seen so many, they are experimenting so many openers. My view is, why not give this kid a chance and, you know, see how he goes by it. Well, we thought that he will be someone who can represent the team. So we asked that from Pathum, and he said, I don't have big hopes, and if my performance is good, I'll get the chance to represent the national team one day. As a batsman, I have no issues with the position or the conditions. I'm confident and able to play anywhere in the order and anywhere in the globe. He said, condition doesn't matter as a batsman. If you're a batsman, you should be able to play anywhere. I mean, we have the Australian series, then we have the South African series. So if Thirumal or someone opens, Kusal Pereira opens there, if they fail, and I think they can go for this option, including the South African series. But there once again, there's another issue, because he'll be playing in a different country, different conditions. What if he fails? I mean, he's bound to fail. Let's say too much as he gets, he failed in too much as, what will the selectors do? Will they have faith in him and go and continue with him? Or we have the same thing that happened to Udhar Jayasundara sometime back in 2015 when he toured to New Zealand, and then when he underperformed there, yes, you expected the difficult conditions. When you underperformed there and he was dropped from the team, and now he has left the country because he feels he's on the right feet for him. He didn't get the chance that he deserved. He got the chance, he failed in two matches, and selectors lost hope in him. Will the same thing happen to this young man if they do so? So that's a good big question. The other thing is, now we have seen a number of youngsters performing exceptionally well in the domestic circuit. To name a few, Chamika Kalmaratne has shown everyone that he can be considered as a genuine all-rounder. He bats deep down. With Ireland A, when Pathum scored a double century, it was Chamika who scored a century coming down the order. So he can hit the long ball, stay there, bat, and then ball as well. 20-year-old batting all-rounder Kamidu Mendes has shown his talents very well. Kamidu has been showing good form in this day cricket. You know, he is someone who can come into the ODI team or the T20 team. Pathum is someone who can come to the test team. Chamika is someone who can play all three. And then we have Priyamal Pereira, the 20-year-old Coles player, scored 2 back-to-back double centuries in the Premier League tournament recently. This same tournament, he scored 2 back-to-back double centuries. Well, that's something really impressive as a 23-year-old boy doing that something. That's good. And then we have Lasith Boldenia, the 22-year-old former Royalist, has taken 108 wickets in 18 matches. I mean, 108 wickets in 18 matches is something really impressive as a spinner. We have seen Rangan Herath retiring. We have Dilruan Pereira in the team as the main spinner. Then we have Akhil Dhananjay. I mean, he's having issues with his bowling style and everything, but he has made that. But then, yes, Lasith Boldenia is someone who can be a good replacement. And then the 22-year-old Thalithu Ratnayake is the second highest wicket taken in the Premier League. Another young name, another name that can come. Shamu Ashan and Charit Asalanka have been showcasing their talents too. Well, yes, they have been doing really well in the middle. I mean, they bat at the middle, Charit Asalanka and Shamu Ashan. I mean, both can roll their arms as well. And then you have Shailendra Ushan, who has performed really well. Okay, so it would be really interesting to see who out of these youngsters these youngsters are really knocking hard at the national level too. I mean, they're saying, look, we are here, we are the replacements for the future. If our series fail, we are there as backup players, and we can come and perform really well. So they are knocking the doors at the national level, and it's really interesting to see from these youngsters who will get their chance first. We have seen Kamalvendi is getting the chance in the T20 tournament, but after that he was not included. He played well in that Indian T20 match, but we thought that he'll be included in the ODI series, but no, still no. We are waiting for it. We will see who will get it. Chamke is one all-rounder, genuine all-rounder, who is doing really good. Pathum is definitely a test playing. He has the test temperament, patience, stability, everything is there with him. So it's about you looking into the future 2-3 years. I guess it's going to be a good, bright future for Sri Lanka cricket. So let's wait and watch how these players will, whether these players will get their chance, or whether these players will be able to showcase their talents in the national level. Thank you.